density is equal to Z into M by Avogadro number into A cube. A is given as how much, sir? Hello?
362
picometers is 362 into 10 to the power minus 12 meters into 10 to the power 2. You have to convert into centimeters. Meter multiplied with 10 to the power 2 will be centimeters. Is equal to 3.62 into 10 to the power. How much, sir, it is? How much it is, sir? Now, what is density value they gave? Hello?
8.92 gram per centimeter cube. Sir, 8.92.
Why you said 3.92, man?
I said 8.92.
8.92
gram per centimeter cube.
Into Avogadro number. Into A cube. A cube means this cube. 10 to the power minus 24 into 3.62 can be approximated as 4. Let me say quickly. 4 is 16, 64. Let us make it some 55. Approximately. Otherwise, I have no time to do that. Divided by M. What is mass? Molecular mass? Hello? What is molecular mass, sir?
63.55.
Okay. Let me approximate it as 64, then I can cut both fellows. Now, what is the answer, sir? I am just cutting these two. What is the answer like?
4.
6.02 into 8.92. Let us make it 9. Into 10 to the power minus 1. Okay, sir. Yes, sir?
Yes.
Hello? It is nearly 5. Answer cannot be 5. Either it should be 4 or 2 or 1. Because it is nearly 5, I am thinking it is 4. My answer is FCC. See, I have not wasted my time in making fine calculations because I don't have time. If I have to do very accurately, I have to spend 10 minutes on it. In normally IIT mains exam, how much time will be available, nobody knows. Actually, the problem here is, here you have to take cube of 3.62. How to take cube of 3.62, sir? 3.62 into 3.62 into 3.62 into 10 to the power minus 24. And you should divide the entire thing with molecular mass. What is the molecular mass they gave?
63.55.
Now, if you use calculator and solve, you get 4. But do we have that much time? No.
No.
Therefore, what I should do? I should go for approximation. If I keep on doing approximations, a stage will come where my approximation will be very close to reality. It requires practice. How to approximate? Normally, you can think that if it is 4, 4 fours are 6, 6 fours are 64. So, this is very close to this. Very quickly, I can cancel this. Now I am left out with how much? Here I have 6. Here I have 8.92. Yes, sir? If I think it is something, you know, here I made a lot of increment. Therefore, I should make a decrement here. So I can think approximately it is 40. Then it will be 40 to 10 to the power minus 1. It is 4. How to do approximation is a matter of practice and intelligence. I can't say how you will do. If you can't approximate, you do laterally and take your time. You use a calculator and solve. Because nowadays there is only online exam, right? Therefore, I think you may be allowed to use calculator. Are you allowed to use calculator, sir?
Yes, sir. In KVPY exam, we were allowed.
So you can use calculator and see what is the answer. Answer is 4. If answer is 4, it is FCC. Now again, I want to look at this. There is some confusion. Whenever they give me density, whenever they are giving molecular weight of a solid, I know Avogadro number. And whenever they give me edge length, using this formula, I can find Z. If Z value is 1, it is called a primitive unit cell or simple cube. If the Z value is 2, I will say body-centered cube. If Z value is 4, I call it as face-centered cube.
Face-centered.
Are we very clear about it?
Yes, yes.
Thank you. Now we are going to next problem. Sir, our target is to do 30 problems. Can we really reach our target? Let me see. Sir, first problem, anybody having doubt? In Bragg's equation, n lambda is equal to 2d sin theta. Yes. N value for second order diffraction is 2. And the lambda value is to be found out. And the theta is given as 90 degrees. Distance between the layers is given as 2.28 angstroms.
Sir, once can you do, sir, this one?
I don't know. So I'm doing this problem also. Let us not be in a hurry, for God's sake. Let us do very slowly. L lambda is equal to 2d sin theta is a Bragg's equation. He has taken, you know, crystals as layers. When he passes X-ray, if the X-ray is traveling through two layers and then getting deflected, this is angle of incident, it is angle of reflection, that is theta. Notice, if it is passing through two layers, n value is 2, second order diffraction. If the X-ray is passing through only one layer, n is 1, first order diffraction. If the X-ray is passing through, say, four layers, that is fourth order diffraction. In our given problem, it is passing through two layers. N lambda is equal to 2d sin theta. My job is to find the lambda. Lambda is equal to 2d sin theta by n value. 2 gets cancelled. Lambda is equal to d. What is the d they gave?
2.28 angstrom.
Into sin 90 degrees. So sin 90 is 1. Lambda is equal to 2.28 angstroms. Is it really difficult, sir?
No, sir.
I don't know. Okay. Sir, please ask me everything. Everything is important for me. Every doubt is important to me. Every student is important to me. Okay? If you don't understand one chapter, you can say, this chapter I did not understand, you repeat. Everything is fair to me. At the end of the day, you should get satisfactory marks. The ratio of anion radius to cation radius in a crystal is 10 is to 9.3. Then the coordination number of the cation in the crystal is. What is this, sir?
8, sir.
Because 8, sir. Cation ratio by anion is 0.93. Always the radius of cation by radius of anion, if it is more than 0.73, coordination number is 8. If the R plus by R minus is less than 0.73, greater than 0.414, coordination number is 6, like that. Look at the question number 4, assertion. White tin is an example of tetragonal system. For a tetragonal system, auntie is equal to boy is equal to chutney. Alpha, beta, gamma are not equal to 90 degrees. True or false, sir?
R is wrong, sir.
White tin is an example of tetragonal system is true. True, no? White tin and tin oxide. You can see in your table. If you have a doubt, you can go back and see the table. I want you to remember that table. This is the table, I think. Tin is tetragonal. Tin. Tin, white tin. Tin has 10 isotopes. That is one quick. Tin is the element that has many isotopes. Tin is starting with the T. Tetragonal also starts with the T. In tetragonal system, A is equal to B, not equal to C. Alpha, beta, gamma, all are 90 degrees. Therefore, for tetragonal system, hello? Hello, who is this, sir? Namaste. Your name? Chapan, sir? One second, sir. Hello.
Yes, sir.
I'm sorry, there is a block. Very, very sorry. I'm extremely sorry. Actually, I don't want to waste my time, but people will make waste time. Sir, so what is the answer, sir? A is equal to B, not equal to C. How to remember? Do you remember? I told you how to remember.
Yes, sir. CTO or HMT.
So, now, can you tell me whether this question, where is that question? What page number can you remember? We have to do 30 questions, man. Page number, sir.
Sir, previous year questions.
Wait, man, my blood BP is rising. I have less time. and we have to do 30 questions. That is my target. Sir, white tin is an example of tetragonal system is perfect. A is equal to B, not equal to C, alpha, beta, gamma are equal to 90 degrees. That should be the reason. So answer A is right, R is wrong. Okay. Next, the length of the unit cell is 5 angstrom. The smallest distance in angstroms between two neighboring metal atoms in a face-centered cubic lattice is. Can you work it out, sir? Sir, I want you to work question number 5, 6, 7. Take time.
So one, can you explain seventh one?
Sir, fifth one is 3.535.
Yes, sir. What is the status? 25 questions. I don't know what we can do. Yes, sir. Sir.
Seventh one, sir.
For the question number 5, sir, first we see easiest question. Whenever they are given 3 questions, very quickly you should see what is easier. The number of octahedral tetrahedral holes present in hexagonal close-packed crystal of X atoms. If for X atoms, how many tetrahedral holes will be there, sir? 2x. How many octahedral holes will be there, sir? X. Any problem, sir?
No, sir.
But the issue comes with the
seventh one did not understand.
Two x and x is 2 in case of cubic systems. If the system is hexagonally close packed, then the number of voids can differ. If you carefully see the number of tetrahedral octahedral voids in HCP crystal, like your both will be x. Hello, there is some noise I'm hearing. From where it is coming? Which are the following elements? Please remember one point, sir. In cubic systems, whether it is face centered cube, simple cube, or body centered cube, in any cubic system, tetrahedral octahedral voids will be in the ratio of 2:1. Whereas in hexagonal close packing, the number of particles in the body are something different. So here it comes XX. Leave that idea. Go to question number 6. Question number 6. Which one of the following elements, when presented as an impurity in silicon, makes it a P-type semiconductor? A P-type semiconductor is formed due to doping of an element with a lower number of electrons than 4. Silicon has 4 electrons. So if you dope it with any element that has less than 4 electrons, maybe boron, aluminium, gallium, indium, and thallium, you get P-type semiconductor. So answer is 3. If the length of the unit cell is 5 angstrom, smallest distance in angstroms between the two neighboring metal atoms is how much, sir? Please notice A by 2. What is that, sir? A by?
So sir, A by root 2, sir.
Then a face center cube. Root 3A is equal to 4R. Root
3A
is equal to 4R. Always 2R is equal to nearest.
Sir, no voice, sir.
Yes, sir.
So what is the answer, sir? 2.5 into 1.73. How much it is? You have to do it correctly. What is the answer given, sir?
Sir, we are doing for BCC, sir. But in question, he gave FCC.
He gave what? I did FCC. Not see the question because I got D-link. It is for BCC. If they give FCC, root 2A is equal to 4R. Then 2R is equal to root 2 by 2A. Is equal to, A is given as how much, sir?
5, sir.
5 by 2. Into 1.414. 2.5 into 1.414. Answer is how much, sir?
3.325.
You can keep on. So let me sum up what all you have done. Whenever you are asked a question on distance of closest neighbor, always the distance of closest neighbor is equal to 2R. Are we very clear? Hello? Yes. Next. In a FCC, always notice that in a face-centered cube, root 2A is equal to 4R. So nearest neighbor distance is equal to root 2 by 2A. What is your doubt, sir?
What is this 4R, sir?
It is a face-centered cube. You have a particle here. Your particle here, 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 and also here. Can you see that? Then it is called face center cube. Agreed or not?
Yes,
hello?
Yes.
So really in a solid, particles are touching each other. So this fellow will be touching these fellows. That is called close packed arrangement. If all atoms are of same size, this diagonal is equal to root 2a, because it is a, it is a. Can you see it really? Hello? Yes, sir. So root 2a is equal to 4r. Any problem?
Sir, how 4r, sir?
Sir, this is
understood,
a sphere.
Understood, sir.
Do you agree it is equal to r?
Yes, sir.
Hello, is it equal to r?
Yes, sir.
Is it equal to r?
Yes, sir.
Here there is a ball. Is it equal to 2r?
Yes, sir.
So this root 2a is equal to 4r. Yes, sir, no?
Yes, sir.
This is equal to how much they gave? 5.5 something. But the nearest neighbor distance is always equal to 2r. This is the nearest neighbor distance. It is always equal to 2r. So 2r is equal to how much, sir? Root 2a is equal to 4r. 2r is equal to how much, sir? Root 2a by 2. Yes, sir, no? Hello? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Still there is some confusion. 4r is equal to root 2a. Just now I have shown. 2r is equal to root 2 by 2a. Any problem?
No, sir.
Sir, in a body-centered cube, do you know that root 3a is equal to 4r?
Yes, sir.
Then 2r is equal to root 3 by 2a. Yes or no? Okay.
Yes. Yes.
So now let us look at the summary of what we have done. All the questions, and then we have to do 15 questions. That is the target. Sorry, I can't leave you unless you do targeted questions. I want to check up that I have done them correctly with no confusion. For a catalyst, the angle of diffraction theta is 90 degrees. In fact, not for a catalyst, it is for a crystal. Two, there are so many printers tables. For a crystal, angle of diffraction is theta, 90 degrees. The second order line is angle value of D, 2.28 angstroms. What is the wavelength of X-ray used in back diffraction? Formula is N lambda is equal to 2D sine theta. N is the order of diffraction, that is 2. Lambda I have to find out. D, distance between the layers, is given as 2.28 angstroms. Theta is given as 90 degrees. Apply the formula. For this problem of density, use the formula density is equal to Z into M by Avogadro number into A cube. Always A value should not be taken in picometers. It should be taken in centimeters. Picometer is multiplied with 10 to the power dozen to get meter. That is multiplied with 10 to the power 2 to get centimeter. In other words, picometer is cancelled. You put 10 to the power 10, minus 10, you will be getting centimeter. Cut the picometer, put 10 to the power minus 10. You get centimeter. Any difficulty, sir? Hello? Cut the picometer, put 10 to the power minus 10 to get centimeter. Are we very clear? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Always look at R plus by R minus to arrive at the coordination number. Please remember the 7 crystal systems, ABC value, alpha, beta, gamma values and examples. Always nearest neighbor distance is equal to 2R. Whenever you are doping a 14th group element with a 13th group element, you get P-type semiconductor. If you dope with a 15th group or 16th group element, you get N-type semiconductor. In a cubic crystal system, tetrahedral voids are double the number of octahedral voids, not in HCP system. And P-type semiconductor is obtained by doping 14th group element carbon, silicon, germanium, tin with a 13th group element like boron, aluminum, gallium, indium, thallium. Are we very clear about it, sir?
Yes. Hello?
Now, I want you to try some problem. Look at problem number 6. Can you solve? Whenever you take a cube, always the body center of the cube is octahedral void, edge center is octahedral void. In every cubelet, there will be one tetrahedral void. There are 8 cubelets. I have shown you the diagram yesterday. So, what is S in this example, sir? Hello?
Octahedral void.
It is an octahedral void. Notice every edge is shared by four other fellows. Therefore, all the 12 octahedral voids are shared by four unit cells each. Therefore, their total contribution is 12 into 1 by 4, 3. There are three octahedral voids in the edges and one octahedral void in the body center. Total four octahedral voids per unit cell. Whereas total eight tetrahedral voids per cubic unit cell. Silica can be crystallized as well as amorphous. It is crystalline amorphous. Crystalline forms, as we studied in 11th class, are quartz, crystallite, tridymite. Amorphous forms are also there. They are called agate, onyx, jaspar. Now let us see. Crystalline, the SiO4 tetrahedra are randomly joined, giving rise to polymeric chains of three-dimensional sheets. They have high melting and sharp melting points, which 1, 2, 3 are not matched with amorphous solids. A amorphous solid can never have sharp melting point. Agreed or not?
Yes.
Hello? So, an amorphous solid is not really crystalline. Yes, sir? So, yes. Which is not at all matching for amorphous solids, sir?
1 and 3.
Okay, sir? The random assortment is there for amorphous solids. NaCl is doped with 10 to the power minus 3 mole percent of the previous IIT question. All these are previous IIT questions. Can you say the answer, sir? The cation vacancies is equal to? Hello. How many cation vacancies are? 10 to the power minus 3 mole percent. 10 to the
Option
power
three.
Minus 3 into Avogadro number by 100. How much it is, sir?
Option 3, sir.
Option 3. Yeah, I want you to try all these questions. Randomly from these questions, you get 25 questions. Anywhere I can ask. For example, can you try to answer question number 17? Hello, sir. All corners put together are 8. Hello. Hello. All corners put together are 8. And each corner is shared by 8 unit cells. So their contribution is 7 by 8 in this case. B atoms are there in phase centers. There are total 6 phase centers. Each phase center is shared by 2 unit cells. Therefore, the contribution of all phase centers is 3. Therefore, I should say that A's are 7 out of 8, 7 by 8, and B's are 3. Now, how can I simplify it, sir? 7 by 8, 3. Multiply both with 8. It will become A7, B24. Are you understanding or you have any difficulty? Only this question I want to explain slowly, very slowly. I am not in a hurry. Ladies and gentlemen, every cube, even your room, which is cubical, has 8 corners. Look at your room. Does it have 8 corners? It has 8 corners. If you keep on constructing so many rooms above, below, and besides, you would see that every corner is shared by 8. So all the 8, because each position is shared by 8, contribute only 1 by 8. 8 into 1 by 8. That is, one particle will be there due to all positions in all corners. But out of 8 positions, 1 is missing. So there are only 7 particles. Now their contribution will be 7 by 8. Whereas B particles are there in phase center, every phase center is shared by 2 unit cells. Therefore, there are 6 phase centers. Hence, each face center contribute half. 6 into half is equal to 3. Therefore, the A's will be 7 by 8, B's will be 3. Now, if I take ratio 7 by 8 is to 3, it will become 7 is to 24. Answer is A 7, B 24. You need to invest time to do these problems, as many as possible. And from these problems, for example, can you guess what is the answer to question number 27? Hello. Can you guess what is the answer, sir? Root 3a is equal to 4r, in which case, sir? Body center cube. Root 2a is equal to 4r, in which case, sir? Face center cube. And
A equal to 2r and simple
cube. A is equal to 2r, in which case, sir? Simple cube. So what could be the answer, sir?
One.
Answer?
One.
A short, short question. Can you answer question number 26? The major force binding, the major binding force of diamond, silicon and quartz.
Covalent bond force.
Just it is covalent. Can we solve problem number 29? You have to find A cube. From A cube, you can find A. And that is the solution. From A, you can find the radius, half of it. In body center cube, root 3A is equal to 4R. From that, you can find out what is R. How to solve problem number 29? Density is given. Density is equal to Z into M by Avogadro number into A cube. For a BCC, Z value is 2. Molecular weight is given as 93. Avogadro number is 6.02 into 10 to the power 23. You have to find A cube. From A cube value, you should find A. But always A in BCC is related, like root 3A is equal to 4R. From that, you should find R. I am showing you solution. Question number 29, solution. Oh, solution is not given. Oh my God. You have to work out yourself. Solution is not given. 29, huh? Yeah. They gave me A cube value. From A cube value, they work out A value. From A value to R value. Can you see that, sir?
Yes, hello. Sir.
Okay. So try to solve as many as possible. Don't forget that previous mains questions all you should try. Previous MCET questions all you should try. Remaining questions as many as possible. That is the preparation for exam. Always post your doubts through WhatsApp. I am always available in WhatsApp. I see my leisure time and I clarify your doubts. If somebody is not understanding anything, point blank you should ask. I did not understand. Please repeat. There are no conditions in love affair. Okay? I wish you good luck.
Thank you.
Okay, sir. Should I close the class now?
Yes, sir.
Please prepare very well for exam. Thank you.